Kansas City VIP for the Halloween Tour 2015. And all these guys, you know, touring is hard and it's expensive and you don't really make a lot of money at it. It's really hard to actually just even get gas into your gas tank and to pay for things like all of the sweet merch and stickers and stuff that we have.
Fancy
coffee cups, yeah. And one of the ways that One Eyed Doll can afford to tour at all, because certainly the clubs aren't paying us, are VIPs. These guys pay a little extra to come in and hang out with us before the show and try to come up with something special on every tour and have a really cool time. Tonight, we did a sound check and had the VIPs come in early. How was that? Was that cool?
Awesome.
Yeah, that was good. And we're also going to just do an interview. First, I would like to introduce our VIPs to everyone. And I'm going to ask what your name is, where you came here from, and what your favorite One Eyed Doll song of all time. No, not of all time. Just today. It doesn't have to be the one of all time. Like, whatever song you're feeling today.
No repeats.
Yeah. So if somebody said one.
Yes! Yes!
So if someone said one already. All right, what's your name?
Sarah.
And where'd you come here from?
Omaha, Nebraska.
Wow, Omaha, Nebraska. We're in Kansas City right now. This is crazy. Okay, what's your favorite One Eyed Doll song today?
Pony, the spiky version.
Spiky version of ponies, okay. All right, what's your name?
Andrew.
Hey, Andrew, where'd you come here from?
Omaha.
Wow, Omaha, okay. Okay,
Do you guys, know each other?
We're kind of a package deal.
All right, what's your favorite One Eyed Doll song today?
Duty Bar.
Green
shirt.
Alright. What's your name?
Natasha.
Hi, Natasha. Where'd you come from?
Fayetteville, Arkansas.
Is anyone here from either Missouri or Kansas?
That's majority.
And what is your favorite One Eyed Doll song today?
American Dream.
Wow. That's a ghetto princess song. That's not even, but that counts. That's cool.
Yeah.
You can say Ghetto Princess song or Kimberly Freeman song. Okay. What's your name?
Georgia or Vivo.
Hi, Georgia. And where'd you come from?
Kansas City, Missouri, on the Missouri side.
So still not in the same state. That's what's your favorite One Eyed Doll or Kimberly song today?
Right now I'd have to say Monster.
Has anyone had their choice eliminated? Okay.
Isabella? Isabella?
Hi, Isabella.
Hi.
And where'd you come from?
Up here.
Yeah. Right here. You live in this room.
I was born on this floor.
So you actually live in Kansas?
Yes. Well, wow. Yeah.
Okay. And what's your favorite movie?
Cinderblock.
What's your name?
Junior.
Where'd you come from?
Tulsa, Oklahoma. That's where we live.
Wow. And, what's your favorite ice cream?
Rocky Road.
I knew that. I knew that, actually, I was talking to somebody the other day, and I was like, it was VIPs, and I was like, man, I never can answer the favorites question. It's like such a ripoff, because I don't really have favorites of anything almost. Like, I don't have a favorite flavor of ice cream or colors. I like all colors and all ice creams pretty much, except for a Neapolitan. It's pretty nasty. And I was like, you know, Jason, I'm pretty sure his favorite ice cream is Rocky Road.
Yeah,
I knew that. Figured.
What's your name?
Anais.
Anais?
Yeah.
Okay. Anais. How did you get here? And from where?
She drove me here. From Kansas City, Missouri.
Kansas City. And what's your favorite?
Right now it's probably Ember.
What's your name?
I'm Alex.
Hi, Alex. Where did you come
from? I'm from Overland Park, Kansas.
Okay, and what's your favorite One Eyed Doll song? Second favorite, because...
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with...
Lemonade,
I'm going to go with Black in the Rye.
We already played that song tonight.
Okay.
What's your name?
Ash.
Ash. And where did you come
from? Salina, Kansas.
Salina. You saw us with Mushroom.
Yes.
That was a couple, like, 2 years ago. What's your favorite One Eyed Doll song?
You might play it. I mean, can I say of all time?
All time, yeah, sure.
Believe in me?
What's your name?
I'm James. I'm from Salina, Kansas.
Oh, right. Did you see Kelly Freshman, too?
I did.
What's your favorite?
Committed.
Committed, okay. Anybody have theirs eliminated yet?
No. Billy
had it eliminated twice, okay.
Hey, I'm Jeffrey.
Hi, Jeffrey.
Jeffrey is taking the show tonight. Just a few. Show off your press pass. That's the bat one. The press. It's a different art from Aaron.
And where did you come from?
Norman, Oklahoma.
Whoa, Oklahoma. So how many states? We have Missouri, Kansas, Oklahoma, Nebraska, Arkansas.
Wow.
Favorite One Eyed Doll song?
Today, Lonely.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Jessie.
Hi, Jessie.
Hi.
And where did you come from?
I came from Bloomington, Illinois.
Illinois?
Yeah.
Holy crap. It's like 7 states. Okay.
Yeah, it felt like that driving here.
What's your favorite? Kimberly Freeman and or One Eyed Doll song?
My favorite song is Water Song.
So that song, I don't know if you guys know this, but that song was made entirely out of Kimberly's voice and or body.
And a storm that was happening on my birthday.
Yeah.
It was like this crazy double thunderstorm thing that happened. You know how Texas has these crazy storms, right? You guys never hear about storms for sure, but there was this really awesome storm, and so Jason sampled audio from the storm. And in the very beginning, you hear this, like, whee thing. That was actually a horse whinnying. And so there's some wildlife in there, and the sound of the thunder.
Yeah, and the kick drum sound is on your chest.
Right, we just played my body for the song. So everything you hear, and the shaky wrist thing is a bracelet that I had been wearing.
You'll hear, like, a back crack of it, a crack.
Yeah. We did my eyelids.
You can hear some like slushy sloshy stuff. Yeah, your eyelids.
I love this song even more now that I did this.
Yeah, teeth chatter.
Yeah. So and then all of
so
the,
like the song is completely a cappella.
Yeah, all of the background stuff is your whole voice, you know,
and the environment storm that's happening. It's really Jason's talent as a producer that produced that.
Just able to sample her body and use it as that's.
This crazy idea that made it actually work, so.
What's your name?
I'm Norm.
Hi, Norm.
Hi, Norm.
And where did you come from? Bloomington, Illinois.
Norm is the... He discovered Norman, Oklahoma.
Yeah.
It's Jebediah Norman, Oklahoma.
My great-grandpa.
Yeah.
So,
that was him. It's Norm.
So Norm always likes to brag about the songs that he has written that no one else has heard. So what's your favorite Kimberly Freeman song?
Today it's Learn to Fly.
Okay, what's your name?
Oh, Joker, obviously.
Joker, no. Yes.
Hello, Joker.
The prettiest Joker you ever saw.
It's JC. So close. Hi.
Where'd you come from?
Amsterdam, Missouri.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, boring. It's not. It's about this big.
You have to stand on your tippy toe to
get it. Yeah.
And what's your favorite One Eyed Doll slash?
You're a Vampire.
Nice. We did You're a Vampire kind of last night, didn't we?
Oh yeah.
There's this super cute kid, Ben. And his mom told me that he sings "You're a Vampire" at home all the time. It was so cute, and he was just all about the show. And so we, after the show, and everybody was gone from the venue, we brought him on stage and sang it with him. I hope there's video of it because it was really cool. He was just like, he's super getting into it. He just go like, "Rawr!" once in a while. It's just like, he's the cutest kid.
What's your name? Brendan.
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 Yeah. And Columbia, Missouri.
Columbia and Amsterdam.
Is there every yeah, that's weird. It's like Texas is that way too.
Yeah, like Harris.
Iran, Texas, you know. It's, yeah, everything is.
What's your favorite one at all?
Probably be my friend. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. What's your name?
Eric.
Adrian,
Missouri.
Man, your makeup is great.
She did it.
Really looks like your mouth is that big.
Props to her.
Yeah, seriously, good job.
What's your favorite one?
Probably Plumes of Death.
What's your name?
Billy.
Billy.
And the last song I heard was probably Battle On.
Battle On.
Billy was on our crew last tour. He was our stage tech, and now
yeah,
see that?
Yeah, still.
And you're like, "What do you have to say, crew badge?" The microphone. And he works here at Aftershock, so it's like old family reunion.
We stole him from here in the first place.
Hang out with Billy. Yeah, they let us borrow him in the first place.
And Eric is also meets Colonel.
My name's Tots.
Eric Tots Christensen. And where did you get that nickname, Tots, Eric?
It's because they're my nipples.
It's true. It's what his wife calls his nipples.
Yeah, they're my nipples.
That's why I always introduce him as Eric Tots Christensen on the stage. And I always go like that. If you notice, I'm always Tots Christensen. That's what that's about. Hi, Rin, if you're watching. Hey. She's probably home making soaps right now. Eric and his wife, Rin, make all-natural soaps. And they actually made some One Eye Doll soaps for the tour, so they're on the merch table. If you're lucky enough to grab one before they're gone, they all smell good. There's clove.
Sandalwood.
You're going to be stinky. Yeah, you're going to be stinky. Everyone should bathe, Billy. Yep. Everyone should bathe.
What's your favorite One Eye Doll song?
Afflicted.
Afflicted. All right. Cool. Yeah. All right. Okay. So what we're gonna do now is, if anybody has a
wait, what's your name?
My name is Nathan.
Hi, Nathan. Where did you come from?
I live in Kansas.
What's your favorite One Eye Doll song?
Break.
Oh, you're next. What's your name?
You've already got three of them. My name's Eric.
Hi, Eric. Where did you come from?
Fall City, Nebraska.
And now, the question of the day. What's your favorite ice cream?
God, there's so many. Remakes and dick.
Well, that's everybody's favorite. What's your other one?
Normally it's Rocky Road, but I...
Yeah, that one's already been taken.
Go there.
Like, okay, if it was in a milkshake, what would it be?
Funky Monkey.
Ben and Jerry's?
Chunky Monkey, yeah.
Yeah, Ben and Jerry's. That's the bomb. It's the bomb. You know what I've been really enjoying lately is... Is it Ben and Jerry's? Coffee Toffee Crunch. It's got these pieces of toffee that are like this big in it. And somehow the toffee is like way better than whatever random Heath bars you can get. It's so good. I'm a sucker for coffee ice cream. And what's your name?
My name's Christian.
Christian? I'll bet you're a rock star, huh?
I wouldn't call myself wrong.
Christian is on tour with us right now. He's in a band called Run 2 Cover. And they're super awesome. They play every night right before our other buddies, Stitched Up Heart. So y'all out there watching, make sure to get to the show early so that you can catch not only your great local acts, but these guys. They're super, super, super talented. They're going to be huge stars. So someday we'll be lucky enough to open up for them.
And they're not going to ever call me.
Yeah, they won't let us open up for them. But, you know, we can write a cool pop set that'll go, that'll be worthy. And so, yeah, it's been really awesome having them on tour. And what's your favorite Run 2 cover song?
My favorite of my own song that I wrote? Probably Like the Way It Hurts is my favorite one right now.
All right, everybody, go out to the internet to find Like the Way It Hurts, and then you'll know why it is Christian's favorite song, because it's awesome, pretty much. And these guys have a tour diary going, so they're, like, blogging how mean we are to them and stuff. So you go check that out. Hello. Hi, how are you? I'm Kimberly. Where did you come here from? Well, I was born in Columbus, Ohio, but I came here from Tulsa, Oklahoma today. That's cool. Who's your favorite fan? All right, thanks a lot for tuning in. That was a great interview, guys. It's time to wrap it up. Of course, maybe the actual interviewer wants to ask us questions. I don't know. Do you want to ask us or any of our fans questions?
Sure.
This is really a professional interview that we're having today.
Okay, well, we'll ask. I'm going to make this a hard one. What's your favorite thing about One Eyed Doll? Anything to do with the music.
Wait, you're asking these guys?
I'm asking all of you.
Kimberly's hair.
And that's to do with music.
Oh, there's one. Kimberly's hair.
It's pony. It's beautiful.
Unicorns.
Unicorns, actually, yeah, that's not necessarily about.
Would you ever do a cover, and if you did, would you do, like, Crazy by Betsy Cline?
You're such a weirdo. But you know what? It's funny, because that has been a discussion lately. Yes?
No, I'm thinking.
And yes. Both of those, yes. I love Patsy Cline.
We did do a
cover. You already know that? You sneaker. A cover song that's on one of our albums. All right. What? Who originally performed "I Am a Viking"? Yngwie Malmsteen, and the vocalist on "I Am a Viking."
Anybody
know
the singer?
Kimberly Freeman. The great, me. The great Jeff Scott Soto. And that he, you know, I love Yngwie Malmsteen, of course, all respect as a guitarist, but I'm really all about Jeff Scott Soto. His voice is what made me want to do that song. So, and that was the first, you know, cover that we ever released, because we have so much of our own music that there's just not a lot of room for anything else, and I just hardly ever think about doing that kind of stuff, but that one, you've got to go to YouTube's and watch the Live in Japan 1985 Tokyo, Japan footage of I Am a Viking. Oh my gosh. If you do not fall in love with Jeff Scott Soto over that performance, you have no heart. I try to do some of his dance moves sometimes. He does this, like, swagger thing. He's like 8 feet tall, so it's hard to reproduce, but yeah, fabulous, Jeff Scott Soto.
Any other,
that's why we did that.
We have an interview question.
So you do a lot of remixes of your older songs. Do you have any plans for any others?
Well, that's a good question. So something that we do on our website is we have all kinds of different tiers for how to get our music. You can get our music on our Bandcamp page, which is name your own price. So you can actually choose zero and just download it for free. Or you can buy a CD for like $10, or you can get any number of other packages. And the Ultra Super Deluxe package on a couple of those is that you can ask for any of our songs to be redone, remixed into any other style.
Yeah. And if we think it's a good idea, which so far really have, there's been a little bit of back and forth about a couple of them.
Like, well, what if we did it this way?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, okay, that's awesome.
This has to be something that we actually want to do. But yeah, we'll remix. And actually, some of the songs we even just redid. We redid the performances and everything. So yeah, there's a fan package where you can choose what One Eye Doll song you want to hear in what style. So for example, we did a choral version of Committed. It's in a kind of classic boys choir style. It's really cool. There's a reggae version of Pretty Song. Slayer version of Battle On with guitar solo. A Prague. Oh, that's not out yet. Am I? I meant the Frog. Yeah, little spoilers for you. But yeah, we've done a bunch of them, and yeah, they keep coming in. So we take suggestions.
So
on
that's
that.
On the band.
Yeah, so you get to choose that stuff. Yeah, and I'm sure there are many to come. But if you go to our Bandcamp, there is a whole album just called Remixes, and that's where you can hear all those. And it's really fun. And a lot of people don't even know that's there.
Okay, so I think they're actually going to start probably.
Okay, what is the name of your outfit?
It is The Punk Is Dead. Because I'm funny.
It is The Punk Is Dead. It's dead punk. That's good.
Okay, in that case, we have a few more minutes. Any other questions, burning questions for this interview that anyone has ever had that they want to ask about One Eye Doll or Kimberly?
Yes?
Why did you do that? I don't know.
Your nose was touched, I'm afraid.
Oh, will you ever do like a country folk tour?
A country folk tour.
Yeah.
Tour.
I would certainly like to. How many of you would come out to that if we could do like a... if we brought the banjo and mandolin and acoustic guitar out, maybe a fiddle. Yeah, that would be really... We've talked about that in the past. We just have to try to make it happen sometime, so. All right. I have a guest fiddler. And, I don't know how you thought of that.
I don't either.
Anybody else want to have a question, touch their nose? See, now if you itch your nose, you've got to ask a question. It's like being at an auction.
What kind of advice would you have for anyone aspiring to be a musician or anyone who is struggling to be a musician?
Well, man, I'm struggling to be a musician, so I'm not sure. I kind of did it the hard way. There are much quicker ways to get to about where we're at, but I was literally dumpster diving, you know, living in a van when I started the band. So, you know, most people out there actually like have a place to live and a computer and a phone and all of these things that they can use to launch their career. But so I might not have the best advice, but what I did was just right out of the gate started playing shows. Just before I really knew what I was doing. I was still trying to figure out how to turn my amp on, basically, when I was playing my first shows, and it was so embarrassing that I had to get way better way fast. There was no, like, noodling in my garage for a year before I started gigging. It was, like, right out of the gate. And I did a lot of open mic nights with acoustic guitar. Oh, you know what? I do have advice. It's the advice that was given to me when I first started. So when I realized that I wanted to perform my songs, because I had written songs, but it was always just like my poetry, you know, I had hundreds of poems that I had written, and sometimes they came out in melody, and I didn't really think much of it. I just kind of hum it to myself, and I'd never sing for somebody else. But I was in a situation in China where I was kind of had to sing. As weird as that sounds, it's a long story, I won't get into it, but it kind of broke me into singing in front of people. And sometimes I just slip in my little poetry that had music, you know, in my head. Those were some of my earlier songs. And I decided if I got back to the U.S. at some point that I might try them out on people here, you know. And so I went to my grandpa, my adopted grandpa, Bernie Jones. He was a performer all his life. He was a musician, a slapstick comedian, an actor. He was one of the greats. He really was. Back in the day, he played with Judy Garland and Bob Hope, and he was in the Spike Jones troupe. And so I came to him. I was like, Bernie, I think I want to be a performer like you. Do you have any advice? And he's, you know, he's old. He was in his late 80s at the time. And he said, well, first thing you're going to have to do is get yourself a guitar or a keyboard or something that is portable and learn how to play that and write your songs with it. And I was like, well, you know, I think that I'm probably a little old to start learning an instrument right now. You know, I was in my 20s, and most people start that stuff when they're kids. You know, they get lessons and stuff. And I was like, it's too late for me to start doing that. I just want to start doing this stuff now. What do you think if I got a band to play behind me? And, you know, and he said, no, do not do that. And because that's what I was planning on doing in the first place. But he said, you've got to have your own instrument and write your own music with your own instrument, and to be able to perform by yourself, because you can't rely on anyone in this world, especially musicians. So you better learn to back yourself up. And so I said, yes, sir, I'll find a guitar. And he said, hold on, I have my old guitar around here somewhere. And so, you know, over a series of comical events, he ends up finding this guitar that he used to use back in the day, like in the 40s, and he gave it to me, and it was just torn to bits. You know, it had been sitting in this closet for like 60 years or something, and he said, you fix that guitar up, and you learn how to play with that guitar. I said, yes, sir. You know, your grandpa tells you to do something, you say, yes, sir, and you do it. So that's what I did. I was just doing what he told me. And over the years, you know, so I started playing acoustic guitar. I'm like, okay, I'll be singer-songwriter girl. I'm doing coffee shops and open mic nights. And as soon as I figured out what was going on with that guitar, I started writing little simple songs. I actually, Envy was one of the very first ones. It's about like 3 chords in the whole song. And that was just where my fingers made it sound like there was music happening. I didn't really know what I was doing or what the chords were called or anything. And so I started feeling it out, and my poetry started coming out with music, you know, and that just naturally happened. And over the years, you know, I had a band, and I had... It's because it's my spirit animal.
Yeah.
Frogs come around when I start talking about this stuff. What do you think, Frog? So over the years, I started playing with other people, and it was really true. I couldn't rely on all these different musicians. People were flaking on shows and dropping out of the band, and people have their own lives going on. And a lot of times, in the early years before Jason was my band member, I ended up playing a lot of shows by myself. Because the show must go on, you know? Bernie was old school. He's like, the show must go on. You've got to make that show happen if you are physically able to do it, no matter who's with you and who drops out. So yeah, plenty of times I went to play a metal show and I brought my acoustic guitar. It was like, hey guys, it's just me tonight, because whoever flaked on me, you know? So, and that's why I play guitar now. It's only because Bernie told me to. And so I'll pass that on to you. Don't rely on anyone else in this world, especially musicians. Learn to back yourself up. And since there's a frog, it's probably true. Yeah. It's probably good advice since there was a frog there.
I also want to add that you're starting out.
I think it's really important, just from a technical point of view. The advice I always give to bands that are recording with me is that it's better to have one really amazing song than 10 kind of half-ass songs that sound not that great. You want to make everything that you put out there as good as it can be, and you want to hear that song back and just love it before you put it out to anyone else. If it's not there yet, then scrap it and do it again until it's right. And you can apply that to everything. You can apply that to your live show. You can apply that to, you know, everything about your music. Make sure you love it first. Don't worry about what anyone else thinks, because if you don't love it, no one else is going to love it.
If you don't love it, there you'll have some hit that you can't stand 5 years later that you still have to play. It's like I play Committed every single night and I can't get enough of it. I'm just like, that is so fun every single night. So, you know, do play what you love. For sure, he's right about that. And, you know, as soon as you feel like you're capable of it, having a good recording of that is probably a great idea. I mean, that's not exactly what I do. But if I'd known him and if I'd had, you know, his wisdom earlier on, I probably would have done that.
Cool. Okay. I think we're going to wrap it up now. So, happy Halloween, guys. Have fun at our Halloween show. We've got like 5 bands playing tonight, so it's going to be a long night. We'll be on later tonight, 10:30 or something. But cool. Thank you very much.
Awesome.